Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
And welcome to Brighton Lights, where we look at the best local entertainment. Let's start by taking a look at some of the best musical talent performing this week. If hypnotic minimal jazz is your thing, go and see Mammal Hands. They're a trio of like-minded musicians who met while busking in Norwich, and they have a wide range of influences, including jazz, world and electronic music. Their rhythmic and exciting sound appeals to a wide range of listeners, including adventurous fans of both dance and rock. You can see Mammal Hands this Thursday at the Rose Hill in Brighton. Tickets are £8. Next is the most original duo on the British folk scene. Megson have established themselves as a real force in the latest folk revival, with their modern twist on traditional folk music. The award-winning husband and wife duo mix beautiful vocals and harmonies with driving rhythmic guitars and intelligent songwriting. They will be performing new songs and classics at Rope Tackle this Friday. Tickets are £14. Now, one act that will really put a smile on your face is the Bushman Brothers. This alternative English rock band combines exhilarating vocals and guitar with a pounding rhythm section and have been likened to a modern-day Pink Floyd with shades of the Stereophonics. This amazing live band will be performing at Concord 2 on Saturday. Tickets are around £15. Our next artist has been called a killer case of blue-eyed soul, who draws heavily from Amy Winehouse. Elizabeth Hunter is a young recording artist based in New York. She leads her band on electric bass, and her sound ranges from upbeat early Motown style to more relaxed, soulful ballads. Elizabeth is playing her debut Brighton show at the Blue Man this Sunday. Entry is free and you can pay what you like on the door. And there are more great sounds from King Kai Wanda. This four-piece band from Norfolk and Suffolk combines influences from many different cultures. Latin, jazz, reggae, hip-hop and West African music are all present in their upbeat and heartwarming songs. Let me down. You can hear King Kai Wanda plus supporting acts at the Brunswick next Wednesday the 30th of November. Advance tickets are £4. And now for Britain's most successful chart band in music history, Madness, who had a record number of top 20 singles in the early 80s and many more since, are coming to Brighton as part of their first UK arena tour in over 2 years. They will be playing songs from their new album as well as all the old favourites, like Baggy Trousers and It Must Be Love. Madness will be taking the Brighton Centre by storm on Saturday the 3rd of December. Remaining tickets start at around £39. Time now to look at what's on stage, starting with a show that's often called the Standing Ovation Musical. Bill Kenwright's multi-award-winning Blood Brothers is one of only three musicals to surpass 10,000 performances in London's West End. It tells the moving story of twins Mickey and Eddie, who are separated at birth but reunited later in life with tragic consequences. This unmissable show has a superb score and is at Brighton's Theatre Royal between the 28th of November and the 3rd of December. Remaining tickets start at around £15. Now, this year marks 400 years since Shakespeare's death, and what better way to mark the anniversary than by seeing the Shakespeare Review. This glittering cabaret-style musical features a fantastic collection of witty music and skits inspired by the Bard, including hilarious show-stopping numbers and sketches written by a host of famous names, from Cole Porter to Monty Python. The Shakespeare Review is at the Theatre Royal until this Saturday. Tickets start at about £17 and you definitely don't need to be a Shakespearean scholar to enjoy it. For a complete contrast, see Stitch It, a stunning physical theatre show for adults without words. It's performed by Nellie Lewis, who fuses mime with buto, a style of Japanese modern dance. The audience is guided through a woman's journey from childhood to childbirth, aging and death. It's been hailed as practically perfect, with one critic even saying that there aren't enough accolades in the English language to describe how utterly magnificent it is. See Stitch It for yourself at the Rialto Theatre next Tuesday, the 29th of November. Tickets are £10. And also coming to Brighton is Bird Studios' brand new production of the award-winning rock musical Rent, which marks the 20th anniversary of the show's debut. This life-affirming story centres around a generation of struggling artists, addicts and impoverished young people living in the shadow of AIDS. The production features a hugely talented young cast and is directed and staged by many of the original West End creative team. Rent is at the Old Market between the 29th of November and the 3rd of December. General tickets start at £15 and a donation will go towards specialist support for people with HIV. Time now to look at some of the upcoming film releases. And you better watch out, because this Friday, Bad Santa 2 is coming to town. This outrageous sequel to the 2003 film sees the return of Willie Stokes, the world's most depraved Father Christmas. Fueled by whiskey, greed and hatred, the foul-mouthed Willie teams up with his old partner in crime to rob a charity on Christmas Eve. Cue a whole load of raunchy, rude and disgracefully hilarious antics. Bad Santa 2 has plenty to entertain and offend, not to mention lots of quirky Christmas spirit. Is this your spawn? Do I look like I'm... Now, this next film has been hailed as one of the most romantic of the year. A United Kingdom is the incredible true story of the forbidden love affair between the African prince, Seretse Khama, and London-based office worker, Ruth Williams. In the face of fierce opposition, their love triumphed, defying family, apartheid, and the British Empire, and ultimately transformed their nation. This is a powerful and thought-provoking film with a fantastic cast, and it's in cinemas on Friday. For all you sporting fanatics, don't miss the live world premiere of I Am Bolt. This inspiring documentary offers unprecedented access to Usain Bolt, both on and off the track. From grueling training days and global competitions to downtime with friends and family, you'll hear from the sporting legend himself about what it's really like to be the fastest man who ever lived. I Am Bolt also includes footage from London's red carpet premiere, and it's in cinemas on Monday. Out next Wednesday is The Edge of 17, a fresh and feisty teen flick that's been hailed as an instant cult classic. This charming coming-of-age comedy centres around the awkward and angst-ridden Nadine as she frantically attempts to navigate young adulthood. The Edge of 17 offers an honest and hilarious look at the struggles of growing up and accepting yourself for who you are. With a smart script and an outstanding lead performance from Hailee Steinfeld, this is one of the must-see movies of the season. And we end with Allied, a gripping spy thriller set during the Second World War. It charts the relationship between Canadian intelligence officer Max and French resistance fighter Marianne, who meet and fall in love while on a mission in Casablanca. Everything seems perfect until Max learns that Marianne is suspected of being a German spy.
It isn't true. I will prove it.
Look, they heard.
You blatantly disobeyed orders.
You're scaring me.
When the war is over, it won't matter where I am. Hey, what happened to my kiss?
Allied is reportedly based on a true story, and it's in cinemas this Friday. Time for a quick break now. Don't go away.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment. Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
Hello and welcome back to Brighton Lights. Let's look now at what's on locally in the world of comedy. One of this country's biggest comedy names is coming to Brighton next year. Mickey Flanagan has made unforgettable appearances on prestigious shows, including The Royal Variety and Michael McIntyre's Comedy Roadshow. He's also fronted his very own Radio 4 series, and his record-breaking Back in the Game tour of 2013 was the biggest comedy tour in the world that year. Here he is on the effect of watching too much Thomas the Tank Engine with his son.
I'm a massive fan of Thomas. I've got to know the trains again, haven't I? Their little personalities, you know. You think, oh, Toby's turned up. This will be a blinder, this will. He's not a proper diesel or a steamy, and he's square, he plays up a bit, you know? So you're guaranteed a good episode with Toby.
Mickey is performing his new show at the Brighton Centre on various dates in October and November next year. Tickets went on sale last Saturday at around £36. After such a massive month in politics, there's never been a better time to see Brighton's notorious treason show. With a team of over 40 writers and a multi-talented cast, this topical and satirical sketch show is a cross between Have I Got News For You and Spitting Image. The treason show is both ludicrous and hilarious and is at Rope Tackle this Saturday. Tickets are £15 and it's for over 18s. Now this week is Bright Friday Festival, Brighton's antidote to the mad consumerism of Black Friday. One of the many themed events taking place is Fashion Faux Pas, a comedy show about the funny side of fashion. If you're suffocated by designer perfumes or find it bemusing that normally civilized people will trample each other in pursuit of a bargain, this is the show for you. Fashion Faux Pas features a great lineup of comedians and is at Comedia this Sunday. Advance tickets are £7. Next up is Simon Brodkin, who performs as various comedy characters, both on the stand-up circuit and on TV. He's best known for playing the cheerful chav Lee Nelson and for carrying out some very public pranks in character. These have included interrupting Kanye West on stage at Glastonbury and gatecrashing a press conference to throw US dollars over ex-FIFA president Sepp Blatter. This comedy genius will be performing brand new material at Comedia next Monday. Tickets are £15. Also next week, Worthing welcomes the award-winning comedian Aidan Goatley. He will be performing his inspirational five-star show, 10 Films with My Dad, which is all about the relationship between him and his father from childhood until the present day. This riotously funny performance combines stand-up comedy and film, and according to critics, it's the most charming, happy and optimistic show you'll see. Catch it at the Connaught Studio next Thursday, the 1st of December. Tickets are £7.50. Now let's look at what's happening in the gaming and technology world, starting with Final Fantasy XV. This role-playing adventure game has been in development for over a decade, but its release is now only a few days away. This instalment allows you to explore a spectacular open world with plenty of new and exciting characters. And as always, you'll embark on an epic quest to overthrow an evil antagonist in his attempt to destroy the world. Final Fantasy XV features innovative real-time gameplay, action-heavy combat, and immersive graphics, and it's released worldwide next Tuesday for PS4 and Xbox One. And police chases are about to take a new turn in The Crew, Calling All Units. This is the second expansion to the 2014 racing game, and it features 10 new levels, plus new story campaign missions, vehicles, and police versus racer gameplay. You'll be able to drive solo, form a squad, or even help out on an ongoing chase. And the multiplayer twist is that all players of The Crew, whether they bought the expansion or not, can engage in the street racer side of the game. Calling All Units will be available next Tuesday for PC, PS4, and Xbox One. The Crew Ultimate Edition will also be made available next Tuesday. It includes the main game, The Crew Wild Run, and Calling All Units expansions, plus the Season Pass vehicles with their customization options. And there's more massive open world action with Watch Dogs 2, the sequel to the popular 2014 adventure game. Playing as the brilliant young hacker Marcus Holloway, you will explore the birthplace of the tech revolution and attempt to expose the hidden dangers and corrupt use of CTOS 2.0. There are multiple ways to complete missions, and you can expect more engaging heroes, better tools, and a hugely entertaining mission design.
This place is a playground for a guy like me. Welcome to San Francisco.
The PC version of Watch Dogs 2 is out next Tuesday and features a multitude of PC-specific enhancements, including support for full 4K resolution, an uncapped frame rate, and lots of other features. And one game that's due for release this week is Steins Gate Zero. This game is the dark follow-up to the award-winning Steins Gate, which is widely considered the greatest visual novel ever made. In this brand new story, scientist Akabe Rintaro realizes he is unable to save the love of his life and sinks into a great depression, which leads to a series of events that endanger humanity. Steins Gate Zero features new characters and new scientific themes and looks set to maintain the exceptionally high standard of the first game. It releases for PS4 and PS Vita this Friday. Now let's look at the brilliant range of upcoming local events. Don't forget that the UK's only inflatable 5K Santa Run is taking place this weekend. Dressed head to toe in Santa attire, you will flip and bounce your way around the course, tackling 10 giant inflatable obstacles. This crazy and hilarious event is happening at Brighton Racecourse this Saturday. There's still time to sign up, and remaining tickets start from £37. Now, last weekend saw the start of Christmas at the Royal Pavilion, and in December, there's a special opportunity to experience the festivity of the palace after hours, with some exclusive evening tours. Led by expert guides, you'll be taken through the magnificent state apartments, specially decorated for Christmas, and afterwards enjoy a glass of sparkling wine in the great kitchen. The evening tours are taking place on the 1st and 15th of December. General tickets are £35 and you'll need to book in advance. The Royal Pavilion shop will also be open for late night Christmas shopping on the 1st, 8th and 15th of December. You can pick up some really beautiful and unique gifts, plus exclusive Royal Pavilion inspired Christmas tree decorations. And the festivities continue with the return of the Artists Open Houses Christmas Festival. Artists and makers from across the city will once again be opening their houses and studios to showcase a diverse selection of artworks and unique gifts. It's a relaxing way to get ahead with your Christmas shopping, and many artists will also be hosting an array of workshops, classes, craft activities and puppet shows. The festival takes place across the next 3 weekends, starting on Saturday. For details of times and venues, see their website, aoh.org.uk. And for a musical treat, you can't get much better than John Wilson and his incredible orchestra, which consists of some of the world's finest musicians. Since forming in 1994, they have contributed to film soundtracks, performed on British TV, and gained an international reputation for excellence. Have a listen to this.
Clap your hands up, y'all, like, give me some heat, man, heat, man, heat, man. Give me some, give me some, give me some, give me some Dixieland. When you hear that Dixieland, you better clap your hands.
Wow, what a fantastic sound. John and his orchestra, with special guests, are performing their brand new show of musical masterpieces from the movies at the Brighton Dome next Thursday, the 1st of December. The concert will feature iconic songs from films such as The Wizard of Oz, Gone with the Wind, Star Wars, and lots more. Tickets start from £33. So we're really spoilt for choice with entertainment over the coming days. See you next time.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.